Hello and welcome to the Django DRF project, eCommerce. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials which you can watch for free. The link to the YouTube course playlist is in the video description. This course is also available on Udemy, where you can watch the course ad-free, download the tutorial source code, and access all updated tutorials and playlist. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. I am at this point making the assumption that you may already be familiar with a Django view. Now, if you aren't familiar with Django views and you haven't seen the introduction to Django, that's an exercise, an activity at the start of this course, which you can undertake, which gives you a general overview of some of the principles of Django. That will give you a general overview of what a view is and the importance of it. So here, what we're going to be doing is building a type of view, which is called a view set here in Django DRF. So we're going to first create our view set, and that essentially is the logic where the actual request from the client resides and is processed, ready for us to then collect data from the database or whatever it is that we need to do, and then return it back to the client. Okay, so here we have the views. Again, like I said, what's going to happen here, without giving you a lecture or looking at a diagram, let's imagine we have a front-end client. It's going to make a request. It's going to try and get some data from our API. So it makes a request. Now what happens is Django inspects that request and then matches that request to a URL, which we need to set up next. And then that URL is connected to a view. So that's where all kind of the logic will happen. That's where we're going to process that request from the client. So in here, we're going to connect up the data and then prepare the data, define the serializer so that one can then send back the data to the client. If you did have a little bit of time, it'd be well worth just reading through view sets here in Django REST Framework. Now, like everything here in Django, there are different options, different approaches, and we are in this course going to be utilizing view sets here. So this is a type of class-based view. Okay, so if you're not familiar with class-based views, I'll try and give you enough information for you to be able to start and to think in a class-based view way, if you like, if you're only familiar with function-based views from Django. So let's go ahead and create a simple and our first view set. Right, so in our views, let's go ahead and bring in some tools. So from the REST framework, let's go ahead and bring in view sets. There we go. And now we can go ahead and create our first view, right? So, oh, actually, we're going to probably need a model, aren't we? So let's go for from.models. Let's import. We're going to be specifically here just working with category to begin with. We go through a process, the whole process, and then we can roll out the product and the brand. So let's just start with category. Right, so in addition to that, we're going to need our serializers. So let's, from serializers file, from our serializer file, dot being referencing this folder. Let's go ahead and import our category serializer. Okay, so we're going to need that. So I'm just going to drop that away so we can see everything. Right, so from here then, we're going to create a class. So this is a class-based view type of view. So let's call this category view. Seems like a good name. So viewsets.viewset. Okay, extending from viewsets. And this is going to be a simple. So let's just add some a doc type here, yeah? Let's add some documentation. So this is a simple view set for viewing categories. There we go. Okay, so that's what it's going to be utilized for. Hopefully that makes sense to you. Let's go ahead now and define our query set. So we're just defining our query set to begin with. So this is going to be a simple query set for viewing all categories. Let's go for all categories. So we're going to need to build a query set here. So category dot the default object manager, objects.all. So a simple query, which is going to collect all the categories from the category table. Now, at the moment, we don't have any data, so we're going to need to think about that shortly. Right, so now we have that. We are going to need to return data. So we can define, utilize the list function here, the list method. So that takes in self and the request. Okay, so here we're basically just defining what happens, how we're going to return that data. So here we use the list. So this is one of the built-ins to our view set. So we're just essentially just overriding, adding information here, which is going to then return our query set, or it's going to return to the client, sorry, the response in a format which it can handle, which should be JSON. So let's first of all define our serializer. So our serializer equals our category serializer, and we want to pass in self.querySet. So we're just defining the fact that, that's the data that we're using, the query set. Remember, we've collected data from our database, and now we're passing it through the serializer because we want to serialize that data, prepare it for it to be then used at the front end. Now, it just happens that we are using more than one data, or sorry, we're using what's being returned from the query set is obviously multiple data, multiple rows. So we need to define many equals true here. Okay, so we set that, and now that's the serializer set. So we now have told Django to pass that data through the serializer. That's how we're going to then support the process of preparing our data to send back to the user. So what we end up sending back is a response, and that's going to be the serializer's data. So serializer, the data in the serializer. Okay, so we're going to need to bring in the response. So up the top here, apologies if that was a bit too quick moving, from the REST framework dot responses or response, let's import the response. Okay, so that's the tool we need. And let me just, after these years, learn the Mac keys. So that's the entirety of our code at the moment. You can see that we're returning the serialized data to the user, to the front end, to the client. And there we go. So that's our first serializer.